I didn't know PET system when they approached me. I'd never heard of it. So while working at university, I started to be involved as a volunteer animateur, you know, stimulating, building up the work of PEC System Flanders. So step by step, I got deeper and deeper and deeper into PEC System International. And at a certain moment, the Secretary General at that time was meeting the retirement age, so they were looking for a successor, and I was chosen, and that is in 78, and from there on, for 30 years I was deeply involved in PEC System and helped to build it up, not the Flemish section anymore, but the whole international network, as you have seen. It started with 14 sections in a dozen countries, and when I left it at about 100 and something branches, affiliates, small or bigger, in 56 countries. So, and for me it was very obvious, in order to have impact in a peace work, you have to bring all the perspectives together. It was also the time when there were grants at the European Union for developing contacts with Central and Eastern Europe. We use these grants, but at the same time, with other people, we develop contacts in all the continents. We develop the whole context, first Central America, then the other countries, Brazil, Haiti, etc. Later on Asia, Philippines, we had already a section in the Philippines, India, etc., which also brought us in the perspective of other religions, not just Christian religion, not just the Roman Catholic Church. So I think, yes, it is a strength of PEC System. It's also a burden and a challenge, you know, to keep this going, because you have east, west, north, south, very many groups, more than 100 member organizations. They can be small, all of their own sensitivity because of the history of their country and their religious backgrounds, etc. They all bring topics which you have to find a way to bring together, to work together, etc. This was, it's a strength of PEC System, and it was a big challenge to do that. What motivated me in all this is human rights, is the shock to see what people can do to each other. Think of the Shoah, the Holocaust. So that sophisticated societies in the wrong conditions can completely go wrong. So this awareness that it can go wrong, and that we must be very attentive to see the first signs, to be deeply involved, to be on the side of people who try to avoid that it goes wrong. That's deeply in my heart the reason. The Secretary General has to, on the international level, has to find the money to do the things, because the branches contribute to the budget, but a lot of them are so small that their contribution is more symbolic than anything else. So you have to find money, especially to develop contacts in the south, the developing world, and in Central and Eastern Europe. A big obstacle, money. An important challenge was also the diversity, because, for instance, I discovered that some people are very interested in the realities in El Salvador, in Latin America, but not so interested in Eastern Europe. And the groups in Eastern Europe, they came out of communism, they were very critical, reserved towards the group in Latin America who were for liberation theology and more leftist, and they would be more critical of communism because of of the history of what they learned that it was when they were growing up. So this diversity, and that of course meant that in the movement you had people who were more dedicated to North-South relationships or to East-West and Central and Eastern Europe. Also some more on spirituality, others more on human rights, others more on political sensibilization. So you have a lot of, well, that's a big challenge. The achievements are that we brought them together, that we learned to work together, and that actually all these branches, these new branches, the older branches, grew into one family. So I think this is, I'm proud of that this worked out. Already in the 70s, when I started, I got deeply involved in Central and Eastern Europe, and it always took a lot of my interest. I was also following very closely the situation of these groups, these people living in Central and Eastern Europe under communism. Then communism fell, we had groups from Central and Eastern Europe linking to Pashvisti, becoming member organizations in a lot of Central and Eastern Europe, with growing nationalism, with tendencies to the right, with xenophobia, great fear of refugees and migrants. Well, it's also in this part of the world, obviously, but there some political parties are very successful in stimulating fear among the people against anything they don't know. The church in Central and Eastern Europe is stronger, which is a simplification. People who are, these groups who are asking critical questions, who are very important to develop pluralistic democracy, tolerance, understanding that there are different points of views and we have to learn to listen, to debate, to grow together. And that's why we took this initiative, together with two Polish organizations and one organization from Holland, and Pashvisti International. And the idea is to strengthen again civil society groups in Central and Eastern Europe, to reinforce civil society groups in these countries. Of course, this is big. We are talking about some countries who were part of the Soviet Union, of course Russia, but also the Baltic states, Lithuania especially. Some countries like Poland, who was very strongly under communist rule and very much watched by Moscow, because Poland is a strong Catholic, strong country. But there is also countries there is also Czechoslovakia, split now, Hungary, Slovakia, Slovenia, etc. And then they have all the countries of, you have Romania, Bulgaria, and you have the countries of the Balkan, you know, the former Yugoslavia. That's a big group. The most important thing is to influence, to monitor governments in their responsibility towards human rights in their own countries and in countries where they have influence. And in order to do that, you have to influence public opinion, because the politicians listen to public opinion. They will try to influence it, to manipulate it eventually, because they need re-elections and re-elections and re-elections. So it is very important that this work on public opinion is strong, in a strong promotion of human rights, involving addressing politicians, saying the governments, indicating their responsibility. So my plea to the young people is to stick to that, not to abandon, and to work together, not on your own, in networking, which reinforces your courage and it gives you a feeling of support that you're not alone. Mm-hmm.